At the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology, there is an international group of about 20 researchers working under the direction of Professor Jens Kreisel. Funded through the PEARL Research Grant Program of the Luxembourg National Research Fund, they're investigating and developing very special materials. These can be crystalline solids or thin films, and they can do things like convert pressure into electricity. We encounter materials like these in everyday things, like gas igniters. And they save lives by responding within a fraction of a second to convert the impact of a collision to the trigger signal that releases an airbag. These are just two of the more well-known applications for intelligent materials.
We call materials intelligent because they do something intelligent to a solicitation they get from outside. So this means, for instance, you deform a material and the material is intelligent enough to convert this into an electric property and to say to the outside world, hello, I have been deformed and tell you this by an electric property. So smart materials convert one type of energy into a different type of energy. All smart materials are functional materials. They have a function, they've got a property which can be exploited in different types of technologies.
These materials have many properties which are of interest to us, be they electrical, magnetic or optical. Some produce electric voltage when exposed to light, for example, while others change their temperature when placed in an electric field. They are all inspired by a naturally occurring model material, perovskites. The research group in Luxembourg stands in a highly favorable environment for investigating the potential of these materials and developing them for technical applications.
One of the great advantages of our group is it does not sit on its own, but it sits in an environment. Our department of about 170 people allows access to different types of characterization techniques, different types of synthesizing techniques, and simply to a great bunch of colleagues with whom we can discuss our type of science. So we have not only our PEARL group, but we've got access to the whole, what I call the MRT ecosystem. Beyond this, we're also collaborating with the colleagues in materials and physics from the University of Luxembourg. And very obviously, we've got a lot of European and international collaborations. Doing science is a collaborative work.
One of the techniques List is a leader for is Raman spectroscopy, including at extremely low temperatures or under high pressure. The researchers fire laser beams at materials and derive from the way the light scatters off them how their atomic structure determines their physical properties. And in fact, the researchers take these characterization techniques one step further.
We do something that no one else is doing. When we shine with light on a material, at the very same time, we deform the material. So we combine piezo effects with light effect, and we work onto photopiezo effects. So we combine, again, two different types of physical properties. This really no one else has been doing. We are very much excited about this, exploring this in much more detail.
From their success, it's clear the material researchers at List are on the right track. Their work has earned them a grant from the FNR's PEARL program and funding from many other backers. This is a strategy the Luxembourg National Research Fund welcomes to ensure good research stays anchored in Luxembourg. The group has a bright future and now has already grown bigger than originally envisaged.
The great thing about the group is that there is a large variety of people, be it scientific-wise, from fundamental research right the way up to applications. Also, we've got six different types of internationalities. I think it's one of the very strong points of our group, that we have a vibrant community. We love going out together. We do a lot of stuff together. And we've got very large discussions because we've got all these different types of opinions. And with new PhDs and postdocs coming up, there is always fresh ideas coming in there. We are still on a growing speed. We've got a great critical mass really to look into this field of research, which is coupling of physical materials.
The research group is also developing innovative processing methods to bring smart materials into new industrial applications. Jens Kreisel's experts have managed to print ultra-thin transparent layers of smart materials onto substrates like glass or paper using an inkjet printer. This technique can be used to make sensors or microantennas, for example, opening up many new possibilities for application.
One of our visions is to position these kinds of materials in the modern world, especially in the digital world. A lot of applications in the digital world are based on new types of screens, which are sensitive to touch. So when you touch it, there comes a kind of vibration back, and this is in fact the vibration of a piezoelectric material. And we're very confident that this will see its life in future applications.
This precise localized feedback will give future touch screens a new level of user friendliness.
In the future, what we would like to do is even more and more translate our fundamental understanding to technology applications. And our vision is really to be known internationally as a group where we're not only active and experts in a narrow field, but as a group which is known for bringing fundamental research right the way up to technology applications. This is a great challenge because fundamental understanding and technology applications is really two different worlds, and I would like our group to be known to be able to marry these two very different aspects.